Let's begin, children. Are you ready? Okay. The topics to be covered in this class are topics to be covered in this class are first one is classification of living world. Of living world. Second one is R. H. Whitaker's Five Kingdom Classification and Outline. Five Kingdom Classification and Outline. And the third one, the structure of virus. Fourth one is the structure of coronavirus. Coronavirus. Fifth one is different types of pathogens or disease-causing organisms. Pathogens, different types. And the last topic is examples of diseases caused by various causative organisms. First one is classification of living world. Second one is R. H. Whitaker's Five Kingdom Classification. Structure of virus. Then structure of coronavirus. Pathogens, different types. And the last one is various kinds of diseases caused by different kinds of causative organisms. I wish to ask few questions to test your previous knowledge, but not today, that we can do later. I think it is necessary to say about the pandemic disease, COVID-19. Pandemic disease. Do you know what is the meaning of the word pandemic? That I will explain later. What is the name of the disease? COVID-19. We have the commitment to ensure to access life-saving tools for COVID-19, such as practicing most basic precautions like the use of soap, alcohol-based hand rub to clean our hands, the use of mask, and keeping social distance to reduce the spread of this disease. Look, children, based on your syllabus, there is a chapter named Keeping Diseases Away. Keeping Diseases Away. I think it is the fourth chapter of the first part of your textbook. In this chapter, you have a detailed study of diseases, pathogens, disease-causing organisms, etc. Since virus is a pathogen, we should have an awareness about COVID-19. I wish to give you some important points of this pandemic disease and some general idea regarding microbes or causative organisms. Then next, what is your role in this discussion? I am very sure you all have more than enough time to read newspaper and gather information about all this. There is no doubt at all. Whatever it is, you do one thing. After your description, I will give you some questions. Your duty is to find answers and send to my personal number. Then, what does COVID-19 stands for? Or, what is the meaning of the word corona? What is the meaning of the word corona? COVID-19 stands for coronavirus कोरोना वायरस, कोविड, कोरोना वायरस डिजीज 2019, कोरोना वायरस डिजीज 2019. World Health Organization or WHO announced the official designation, that is COVID-19. Coronavirus is continuing its spread across the world. Most people lost their lives. The virus, which causes respiratory infection, people with COVID-19 generally develop sign and symptoms includes mild respiratory symptoms, mild respiratory symptoms, which means it affects in the respiratory system. Respiratory symptoms including fever, cough, etc. The incubation period of this virus is 1 to 14 days, which means we will have the disease after 14 days. Then, first topic we wish to explain, that is classification of living world. The first topic is the classification of the living world. I think you have studied R.H. Whitaker's classification. Do you remember what is its name? It is known as Five Kingdom classification. So here we are going to just to note the outline of Five Kingdom classification. R.H. Whitaker classified the living world into five kingdoms: Kingdom Monera, Kingdom Protista, third one is Kingdom Fungi, and the fourth one is Kingdom Plantae, and the fifth one is Kingdom Animalia. R.H. Whitaker classified the living world into five kingdoms. First one is Kingdom Monera, second one is Kingdom Protista, Kingdom Fungi, Kingdom Plantae, and Kingdom Animalia. Then, Kingdom Monera, what are the soil members? Kingdom Monera, the soil members are bacteria. Bacteria are the soil members of the Kingdom Monera. Then, Kingdom Protista, protozoans. Protozoans are the members of the Kingdom Protista. Then it is clear Kingdom Fungi includes various kinds of fungus such as Ascomycetes, Basidiomycetes, etc. Then here you can see Kingdom Plantae. You all know plants are belong to this kingdom. Then what about Kingdom Animalia? Animals are included in this kingdom Animalia. Virus, what about a virus? Can you see anywhere? Is there any place? No. Virus do not have any place in this five kingdom classification because they are acellular. We are going to study about the structure in detail. The next is structure of virus. Structure of virus. The structure of microbes help us to understand various properties such as how they survive. First one is how they survive. And the second one is how they infect others' body. Then What are the creative ways? What are the creative ways to prevent the infection? To prevent the infection. So I'll explain once again. The structure of microbes help us to understand various properties such as how they survive, how they infect, what are the creative ways to prevent the infection. So here you can see the structure, study of the structure of viruses must. Then virus can only survive in host cell because they have genetic material which enable them reproduce. They have genetic material which enable them reproduce. However, they do not have an enzyme to synthesize protein. So they need other organism. They need other organism so that they use that machinery, this machinery, to reproduce and get multiplied. See, they are multiplied. Means they do not possess any enzyme for protein synthesis. So this virus require other organism. Here we can say it is the host cell. Then they use this machinery for the reproduction and get multiplied. Next, what about the structure of virus? All virus possess a genetic material. This is known as the genetic material. Genetic material is otherwise known as genome. This genome is surrounded by a protein coat. This is known as the protein coat. Actually, this is the genetic material. It is otherwise known as the genome. It is surrounded by a protein coat. The protein coat is otherwise known as capsid. The genome may be either DNA, this is known as the genome. This genome may be either DNA or RNA. This genome may be either DNA or RNA, but never ever it is both. So DNA is a genetic material or genome. RNA is a genetic material or genome. And DNA means deoxyribonucleic acid, while RNA means ribonucleic acid. Viruses have been broadly classified into four types. Means these viruses have been broadly classified into four types based on their genome. Based on this genome, they are classified into four. So we can see what are they. Virus classified into four. Here, based on the presence of the genome, they are classified into four. First one is double-stranded. DS stands for double-stranded DNA. Single-stranded DNA. Double-stranded, again DS, double-stranded RNA and single-stranded RNA. So, double-stranded DNA possess two strands. Then single-stranded DNA virus possess only one strand. Then double-stranded RNA virus possess two strands, while single-stranded RNA virus possess only one strand. Then here our coronavirus belongs to this group, this particular group. That is, coronavirus belong to this particular group. That is single-stranded RNA virus. Coronavirus belongs to this particular group, that is single-stranded RNA virus. Next, we can see what is the structure of coronavirus. I think you all have got an idea about the structure of virus. Next, we have to study the structure of coronavirus. Structure of corona virus. So now you are able to say about this genome, protein code, etc. Here the genome is, yes, listen and tell me what is the name of the genome. Either it is single stranded RNA genome or double stranded RNA genome or single stranded DNA genome or double stranded DNA genome. Yes, it is single-stranded RNA genome. So, we can say single-stranded RNA genome. Then, it is also surrounded by a protein code, and the name of this protein code is capsid. Protein code. Capsid. But coronavirus, there is an envelope present around this protein coat. These envelopes are made up of glycoproteins. Glycoproteins consist of two molecules. They are lipids and proteins. Then the proteins are arranged like spikes and forms rings around the genome. When looked under electron microscope, rim found around the genome appears as corona of the sun, and that is why it is known as coronavirus. Okay, the next topic is types of pathogens. There are different types of pathogens. They are, one, we have studied about one, that is virus. Second one is bacteria. Third one is protozoa. And fourth one is fungus. These organisms cause diseases, so they are known as pathogens. And the last one is, what are the examples of diseases caused by various pathogens? Can you name one viral disease? Yes, AIDS, acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. It is caused by HIV, human immunodeficiency virus. Another one is chickenpox, SARS, etc. There are many examples. Then bacteria, cholera, one example. Another one, TB, tuberculosis. Then some of the diseases caused by protozoa. Malaria is one of the disease. Malarial parasite is the causative organism. Then fungal diseases, ringworm, dandruff, etc. That's all about today's class. What all things we have studied are only basic ideas. Children, if you have any doubt while listening the class, note it down. I will help you to clear the doubts. Do not forget to find the answers and send to me today itself. One more work is there. Write important points and answers in the notebook and show me after vacation. Remember to write the date also. Thank you, children. Thank you very much.